In this video, I'll continue to explain the usage of 15 useful JFR tools and teach you how to quickly repair IGS surfaces. First, let's learn about a few control point tools. Show control points has been explained before. Select the object, left-clicking the icon shows control points, while right-clicking the icon hides the control points. You can also press the ESC key to hide the control points. Insert control point. It allows you to add control points at any location on the surface, and the surface will be automatically uniform. After turning on the control points, you can continue to adjust them. Let's look at the options in the command prompt. Click to switch the direction for adding control points. Sometimes you may accidentally add too many. You can use reduce control points to remove excess control points. Similarly, switch directions in the command prompt. The operation is very simple. Next tool, flatten control points. I'll first create an uneven curve. It automatically recognizes the part with fewer control points and then taps flat to the part with more control points. Select the control points and then click the icon to automatically flatten them. If the side with more control points is on top, it will flatten upwards. The icon of right-clicking is Flatten to Custom Plane. Take an object from the database. Select a prong. Sometimes control points of some objects are messy. We can use this tool to flatten the control points. Right-click the icon, select the points, set a direction. This will flatten them. Finally, use cap planar holes. Next one. Lasso points. This tool works similarly to the lasso points in JewelCAD. Left-clicking the icon activates lasso points. There may be beginners watching this video, so I'll explain in detail. Now I want to select the three rows of control points on the left while avoiding the control points on the right. This tool provides much flexibility. Now I want to quickly select the control points on the right. Just select all the control points once. Demonstrate again. First, select a portion. Then select all. This operation is very convenient. Right-click is frame select, which is similar to Rhino's default selection, but includes the inverse selection function. Next tool. Curve center point. Typically, CNC processes requires us to provide the center point of the curve for the machine to position the cut. We can generate it directly with this tool. Next is flip curve direction. As the name suggests, it reverses the direction of the curve. Look at the direction of the serial numbers on this curve. Just like this. It can be used in combination with rail or other forming tools. Next one. Sort out curve or surface control points. Sometimes curves imported from other software have duplicate control points. Surfaces generated with such curves easily fail Boolean. This tool is generally used to sort out control points. And this is the effect after sorting. Right-click is shrinkage curve control points. the effects of the left and right buttons are opposite. Surfaces will also have duplicate control points or even be interlaced, which is often one of the reasons for Boolean failures. When encountering Boolean failures, you need to separate the control points. Next tool. Flatten control points of surface edge and JFR cap. Now I need to close this ring shank. Note that this opening is not flat. Use cap planer holes to check. The opening below is flat, so it can be closed directly. The opening above was not successfully closed. Because Rhino's cap planer holes requires the opening to be flat. So we need to use flatten control points of surface edge. This will close it directly. Withdraw the steps first. Sometimes I need to adjust the control points of the shank to be regular. You can use the right-click flatten control points. It becomes regular easily. Many times I skip the flatten control point step to save time. And directly use JFR cap to close it. Even if the opening isn't flat, it doesn't matter. If exporting to STL or OBJ format, ensure the object is fully closed. Now, let's understand a concept. Generally, objects after cap cannot have control points opened. Because in Rhino, poly surfaces cannot have control points opened. You must first explode the object into a single surface to open the control points for adjustments. The single surface cap tool solves this problem. After use, the object is closed and a single surface. This doesn't affect our shape modifications. It also has a great use. See that the ceiling position is a right angle. We can use the Make Uniform tool to change it to a rounded effect. In future, we will use it a lot in modeling, such as the ring holder and the prong of the gemstone. This close single surface supports exporting to mesh formats like STL or OBJ without worrying about mesh errors. Moving on to the next tool. We often encounter surface direction disorder. Unified Face can solve this problem all at once. Let's first learn about the concept of normals and how to distinguish between positive and negative. Open Analyze Direction. The white arrow represents the normal. The direction it points is positive. The opposite direction is negative. For this cylinder, the positive direction is inward. Due to the direction difference, Boolean results will also differ. This is the correct result. This is the incorrect result. Previously, we modified individual objects. When there are too many objects, it becomes very troublesome. So, Unified Face is much more convenient. It instantly unifies the direction of all objects. Next one. Finally, let's learn how to quickly repair IGS format. Before JFR could read JCD format, we used IGS format for conversion. Imported objects are non-periodic. So what is non-periodic? Objects with seams or openings like this. In many cases, using Make Surface Periodic directly, the periodicization is going in the wrong direction. you need to swap UV directions to make it periodic. The control points of the seam line are then correct. If there are only one or two, it's fine, but if there are many, it becomes troublesome. This style has a very large number of objects that are imported through the IGS format. The seams are also non-periodic. Repairing each one individually is too time-consuming. Using batch repair IGS allows for batch repairs. Now you can see that all the objects are repaired uniformly. As for surface normal issues, you can handle them in bulk with unified face. It's very simple. The final tool is Super Repair. It's a combination of the previous tools. Using it, you can directly repair and cap surfaces. Choose Yes. You can see that all these objects are now repaired and closed. That's all for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share this video, and subscribe to us. See you next time.